going on, everybody? It's your boy named Matthews, back again with another video. And today we are sitting on our new workbench that we got for the workstation, man. I'm gonna be using this table as like a workbench for sewing, doing embroidery on here, cutting stuff up, probably product reviews. I got a little towel and stuff like that, or a blanket, I'll say, that I'll lay across right along this nice blank wall. This table right here is from Seville Classics. The length of this table going this way, 48 inches long, from top, from front to back, it is 24 inches long. From the floor up to this top where I'm sitting at right now, it is 37 and a half inches in height. And this wood right here is about 1.5 inches thick. I also want to show you guys, let me actually jump off it real quick.
Oh, hurt my ass cheeks on that one, goddamn.
I want to show you guys the legs on this thing real quick. Then came with some legs on it. If you guys seen the little intro or whatever, I'm gonna put it. It actually took me like 2.5 hours, or not 2.5, but about 2 hours or so to put this thing together. Maybe like 1.5 hours, realistically, 1 hour 45 minutes. It does recommend that you use 2 people to put it together. However, I did it by myself and just throwing a movie. And by the time the movie was over, it was already built and set up in the corner here. I do like the fact that this thing is on wheels. It does have locks on the front wheels on both sides. The back ones do not have locks though, but I mean, all you need is, you know, a lock on one side, you good. So I do like the fact that that is on there, and keep that in mind too with this, with the wheels on there and this thing being 37 and a half inches from top to bottom. You can get a little lower if you take these wheels off, because they are some nice size wheels. Don't have the exact measurements, but yeah, if you guys want it to be a little bit lower, that'll help you. And I do like the fact that these are some very wide wheels, so I think they're gonna last quite a while on that. Another thing I do like about this table, especially compared to what I was doing before, if you guys seen the other videos, you know I was using 2 tables, one to kind of like house my scissors and stuff like that, and another to actually have my machine sitting on. Let's actually adjust this real quick. I just had this blanket on here, even though of course this tabletop is nice and brand new and stuff like that. I just got this blanket on here for now because I'm probably gonna do some overhead shots and you know, some product reviews on just a clean looking surface. But also like it, the fact that this thing does have, let me slid it too far down, but it does have a drawer down here. It's got 2 handles, but it actually opens the same way. No matter which one you pull, it's gonna open it. Same thing, does have some dividers in here. As you guys can see, these are some of the most used tools for what I do with graphic design, specifically for like embroidery. So I have a thing here for like bobbin thread and stuff like that. Some more things to make some piping, some loose fabric over here, cutting mat and ruler, all my cutting utensils and stuff like that, some tape and some tools that I use to actually put this together, which is another bonus that this thing came with everything I needed. I didn't have to break out my own personal tool set to put this thing together. It came with it. I'll tell you this much, a lot of times when I actually do stuff, let me turn it around so y'all can see me. A lot of times when I actually be making stuff, I'm like one of those people that refuse to look at the user manual. However, you do need to actually look at the user manual for this, because there are some pieces that fit in multiple spots. You can do it upside down, and you know, the bar that goes in the front, you might end up putting in the back, and it will 100% fit back there. However, it's just going to mess up some certain things. So I did have to read every single step in the manual on how to put this thing together. Again, it was not hard to do. However, it did take a little while to do. So I just threw on a movie, got it done, did a little time lapse and stuff like that. I am liking the table though, and I'm going to be doing some product reviews before I actually use it for its main purpose. Like I said, for like my embroidery machine and stuff like that up here, I'm going to be using just the plain surface right here to do some product reviews on some other stuff that I picked up, some other stuff that my lady and stuff got me for Christmas. So if you guys are interested in seeing that, more videos like that, hit the thumbs up button on this video, subscribe to this channel, and I'll catch you guys in the next review. Peace.